A very good morning. I taught you unit 2 chapter number 9, that is the poem The Try Anti Wanti Gongolo, written by C.J. Dennis. Today we'll go with the meanings as well as with the question answers of this poem. I gave you some homework also, that is first one was write the rhyming words. See here in the first passage, rhyming words: spy, fly; bee, tree. Next para: face, disgrace; scare, there. Next third passage: toes, nose; shame, name. Next para: confess, address; bean, green. These are the rhyming words of the poem, that is the Try Anti Wanti Gongolo. Next, I gave you a web diagram. If you have opened your notebook, you can see the web diagram or the mobile which I have given you in that. You can open that and you can see it, a web diagram, that is the action words. Read the following extract and answer the following verbs or complete the web. T-C-K-L-E. So T-I-C-K-L-E. T-I-C-K-L-E. Tickle is the action word. Second, S-C-O-L-D, scold. S-C-O-L-D, scold. Third, down one, T-R-E-M-B-L-E-S, trembles. T-R-E-M-B-L-E-S, trembles. I think so, I gave you V over there. It is not V, but it is T-R-E-M-B. Right, instead of V, you have to write B over there, sorry. T-R-E-M-B-L-E-S, trembles. Next. S-C-U-T-T-L-E, scuttle. S-C-U-T-T-L-E, scuttle. The question I gave you, first question was, what is the poem about? The first question I gave you was, what is the poem about? The poem is about an imaginary insect named as Try Anti Wanti Gongolo. The poet described its funny ways to disclose in the end that it was all a joke. What is the poem about? The poem is about an imaginary insect named as the Try Anti Wanti Gongolo. The poet is describing its funny ways to disclose in the end that it was all a joke. Second, what does the insect live on? So here, the insect, what does the insect live on? Here, the insect lives on weeds and battle gum. The insect lives on weeds and battle gum. Next question. What does Try Anti Wanti Gongolo do when we call it by its name? What does it do? See it. When we call Try Anti Wanti Gongolo by its name, it makes a sound of contentment with a sense of pride. When we call Try Anti Wanti Gongolo by its name, it makes a sound of contentment with a sense of pride. Next, I'll just take some more few with you now. If I ask you, select the proper alternative and complete the following. Try anti wanty gongolope dash if you tread upon its toes. What answer will come? Smiles, trembles or scuttles? So the answer is trembles. Try anti wanty gongolope trembles if you tread upon its toes. Now we'll go for some of the meanings. First meaning, that is spy, S-P-Y, spy. Spy means catch sight of, Spider, a small insect with 8 legs. Next is beetle. What do you mean by beetle? B-E-E-T-L-E, beetle. Beetle means an insect with wings which are hard. Beetle means an insect which wings are hard. An insect with wings which are hard. B-E-E-B. Bee means an insect which provides honey. An insect which provides honey. Woolly, W-O-L-L-Y, woolly. Woolly covered with wool. Grub, a worm like larva or an insect. Next, that is wattle gum. Wattle gum means an Australian gum. Appetite means desire for food. Disgrace, loss of respect due to one's action. Scare, cause fear. Mope, feel low and dejected. So this was the question answers of the poem and the meanings. You have to write it down in your notebook, as well as keep your book ready whenever we have online classes. Thank you. Have a great day.